If you want to build logistics, at some point you're going to need a shipping container controller. First, let's make the microcontroller. I'm going to name mine container controller and change the width to 4. We need 8 logic nodes. Click the logic tab and add a node. The first is a composite input. I always name mine comp in. And add a second composite node, but change it to an output, and I call mine comp out. Next is an on off node for our top connectors, and change it to an output. And we'll need an on off output for the bottom connectors as well. Now we want to add 2 nodes to control the top connectors. These will be called front top button and rear top button. And we'll do the same for the bottom set. Add 2 nodes and name them front bottom button and rear bottom button. All 4 of these buttons are inputs, so we don't need to change any of them. Now we can go into the logic editor. I'm going to space these nodes out. These 2 at the bottom left are the bottom connector button inputs, and the 2 in the middle left are the top connector button inputs. Then we can put the 2 connect outputs on the right, and I'll put the composite nodes up the top. Push tab to open the logic menu and type OR. Place the OR block, and then click and drag a box around it to highlight it, and press Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to make a copy down beside the bottom connectors. Connect the button nodes into the OR gate. We will be doing this the same on the bottom buttons as we do on the top buttons. Open the logic menu again and search for toggle. We want the push to toggle block. Now make a copy for the bottom buttons. Connect the OR gate's output into the push to toggle. Open the logic menu and search for NOT. I'm going to place and copy the NOT gate. Connect the push to toggle output into the NOT gate. Now we connect the NOT output into the top connectors node, and do the same down here for the bottom connectors node. Finally, we will add a composite right on off. Click the composite right and change its channel count to 4. Connect the top push to toggle to input 1, the top NOT output into input 2, the bottom push to toggle into input 3, and the bottom NOT into input 4. Now just connect both the comp in and comp out to the composite right so that the composite signal can pass through. Save the controller as container controller. And now we can build a shipping container. First, make sure X symmetry is on. Now click and drag 5 blocks out to the side. Then off the edge, click and drag 10 blocks up. Then connect the gap at the top with blocks. Delete the top corners and the bottom corners, and also the block directly beside the corner on the bottom. Open the parts menu by pushing tab and search for connector. Select the electrical connector. The top connectors point up and the bottom connectors face sideways. It doesn't matter which side they point from, as long as the connecting part is in the corner. Open the parts menu again and search for a push button. Select the push button. Now press X to enter erase mode and delete the top and bottom middle blocks. Place a push button in the top and bottom holes we just made. Open the parts menu again and search for instrument panel. Delete the 2 blocks either side of the buttons we just placed on the top and on the bottom. Place the instrument panels in the holes. Use the Select tool and click on the top right instrument panel. Click on Instrument 3, change its name to Connectors On. Change the type to Indicator. And leave it on Channel 1. Now click into the other instruments and set their types to None. Repeat the process with the top left instrument panel. Click Instrument 3 and change its name to Connectors Off. Change its type to Indicator. And change the channel to number 2. Change the remaining instrument types to None. Move down to the bottom connectors and click the right instrument panel. This time we want instrument 1. Change its name to connectors on. Change its type to indicator. And set the channel to 3. Change the type of the other instrument panels to none. Click the bottom left instrument panel and instrument 1. Change the name to connectors off, the type to indicator, and the channel to 4. Change the other instrument types to none. Click the select tool to exit and we can build up the shape of our container. Click and drag 27 blocks long from the top corners. Place a temporary block at the bottom and connect that to another 27 blocks along, and this temporary block can be deleted now. Click the selection grid tool, hold left control and click the top left electric connector to select it. Now click the resize grid button on the right. Drag these purple handles so all the connectors, buttons and instrument panels get selected. Click copy and drag the blue arrow along until we clear the length we set before. Then press O to flip our copy over and press paste. Now use the merge tool to merge the green and red parts together. Now it's time to add the container controller. Open the parts menu and search for container. Find a place to attach the controller and add a battery if you're not using infinite electricity. In the logic tool, change to composite mode. We need to connect this comp in node on the controller to an out signal on an instrument panel, and then chain every subsequent instrument panel together. So go around chaining every instrument panel together and you will end up back at the controller creating a continuous chain. Change to data logic. Click on the top connectors node, then holding left control, click the top electrical connectors in each corner. Now connect the bottom connectors node to the bottom electrical connectors in the same way. Connect the buttons to their corresponding nodes on the controller. This is why you should give your controller logic nodes clear and obvious names. Now connect all the electricity to the battery. And then we can test it. So here's our container and a lineup of some of my other containers. As you can see, we can push the button and it toggles the light and the connection state of the top and the bottom connectors. This DX container uses instrument panels on the side. This orange HCLI container has opening doors. And this HDMI container is used to transport fuel. Thanks for watching, leave us a like if you've made it this far, and I'll see you next time.